What a weekend, man. What a weekend. Boy, did we have a hell of a weekend. We had so much fun. We went Friday night, we went bowling. We went bowling Friday night. Oh my God, we had so much fun bowling. And Saturday night, we went to the racetrack down in Heston. My ears are literally still ringing. Was not prepared for that whatsoever. And then the dust and the dirt and everything from the track got in your eyes, and it was awesome. It sucked to get the dirt and shit in your eyes, but it didn't really like bother me. It wasn't that bad. It was a good time. But yeah, we had a really good weekend. The kids had a good time. And then on Sunday, the boy had to go to work for a couple hours, and then he had a football thing. And he was a little tired and super grouchy and just not in the best of mood, you know. It is what it is. We ended up, took him over for his football thing, and then me and Bailey, my daughter, and Carly, my stepdaughter, we all went down. We went down to the creek, and we all jumped in the creek, and Carly didn't get it because she's a big sissy, but me and Bailey, we went running and jumped. We jumped in the water and had a good old time. It was a blast. Oh my God, we had so much fun. It was an awesome weekend. You know, I love having the kids over. Had all three of them. It doesn't happen all the time, so it was really nice to have them all there. You know, we don't have the biggest house, so we make the most out of it that we possibly can. And I don't know what else you could possibly do, because when you have the opportunity, I grew up in a broken home where, you know, I had step family and back and forth to mom and dad's house. Where I slept at when I went to my dad's house didn't matter. I'm just happy to be there. And I think it's kind of the same way with my kids. They're just happy to be here. They don't even care. They're just glad to spend time with me, which makes me feel good. Like, I just, oh man, that hits me here. Like, makes me feel good that they want to be there. So, I mean, I know that not everything isn't going to be peaches and cream. I mean, it can't always be 1,000% all the time. It just can't be, you know. And I'm having a hard time with saying no. And like giving in and being a pushover, and, you know, being like, all right, you win, you know, just giving in or whatever. And I'm trying really hard to be better about that. It's not easy. It's really not easy. You know, I don't like to say no. I don't like to be the mean guy, I guess, or whatever. Like, I want to have a good time. And you know, I'm like, you know, if you guys want to fight and carry on, you can do that at home. Come to my house. We're going to come to my house and hang out and have a good old time. And it's been a process for me to learn how to do. Anybody has any hints and tips and tricks on that, leave a comment, let me know. But like and subscribe, and yeah, I'm headed for Georgia, baby. Rainy day down through the Bald Eagle Valley here. This is the Bald Eagle Creek right here, not the little Bald Eagle Creek. This is where she starts at. It runs down to Howard and down to the Susquehanna, I believe it runs into, but yeah. It's a rainy day. We're headed for Georgia. We're off. We're headed for Georgia. I gotta be in basically Atlanta. It's just be the southwest side of Atlanta. I can't remember the name of the town off the top of my head. But we're headed for there. It's 12 o'clock. I'm a little later than I wanted to be, but you know. It's a 10 to 12 hour drive depending on how fast you drive and how many stops you make. So I have just enough time to get there. And by the time I get unloaded, they don't start until 8 o'clock. By the time I get all done, I'll have my 10-hour break-in-ish. It'll be close enough. And, yeah. Be able to go get reloaded and take a nap and all that fun jazz. But I should have left a little earlier. I should have left, like, at least 8 o'clock. Somewhere between 8 and 10 o'clock. So I'm a little bit late. I'm going to cut myself short on a few hours, but that's okay. I'll manage. I got to get some good sleep this morning. I got to hang out with my wife and hang out with Carly a little bit this morning. So that was cool. They got me a piece of birthday cake. Well, they got me a cake for my birthday, and we just now finally got a chance to eat it. A week or two late, but that's okay. It doesn't matter. It was awesome. It tasted great. Thank you, baby, for getting it for me. I know you won't watch it, but I'll thank you anyhow. So there's that. Jazz hands. So, all right, guys. Let's get to Georgia. Let's go. I'm hoping to get down there, shoot my bow a little bit, show off my two Matthews hats here. This is my $2,000 Matthews hat, and that's my $50 Matthews hat. Not quite 50, I think it was like $35 with shipping and everything. So there's that. I got a new turkey call. It's not as good as my beeline, but might take a little bit of time to get used to it. I gotta take this other one back. I'm getting ready to send it back to Amazon right now. It's called the Waterboard. Oh my god, the thing sounds like a dying goose. It's fucking awful. But yeah, everybody follow along. Let's go to Georgia. Peace. Thanks for watching, everybody. Please like, subscribe, all that fun jazz. Hope everybody has a great week. Thanks for watching again.